I'd like to introduce you to my good friend, Winston. He's a bit sad today because he's been drawn in black and white, and he thinks that's boring. Winston is black and white because black is the default color for outlines, and white is the default color for filling in shapes. We're going to change those colors with code. First, let's start with coloring in the background. I can do that by typing background up here, and it auto-completes the command for me. And my background is red. All the coloring commands are auto-completed on Khan Academy because these three parameters are hard to figure out yourself. You see, we need some way to describe a color to a computer because computers don't see colors the way that humans do. Here, we're using something called RGB colors. The first parameter is how red the color is. The second is how green it is. And the third is how blue it is. In this one, we're using 255 for red, which is the most red it can be, and 0 for green and blue, which are the lowest they can be. And that is why our background looks red. I want to make this a light blue instead, though. I could try to figure out exactly how much each number should be, or I could take a much easier approach. I can just click on the numbers and use the color picker that pops up and drag around until I find a color I like. Perfect. Now, it's important to understand what this background function is really doing. It's just drawing a big colored square over the entire canvas. If I take this out and I move it to the end here, then it draws that square over everything and it looks like they've disappeared. That's why it's really important that the background function is at the top of our program. Now let's color his face. Remember that the default color of our shapes is white. To change that, we need to use the fill command. I'll type it right here, and once again it defaults to red. Notice, it didn't just make his face red, it also made every other shape red. That's because the fill function basically means use this fill color for every shape that comes after this command. Well, I'm going to start by changing this to yellow. And now, in order to make the eyes and the mouth different colors, I'll just use fill again. So to do his eyes, I'm going to type fill before the two ellipses for his eyes. Ooh, he looks a little bit like a demon right now. So we're going to change that to black. Okay. Now, to do his mouth, I'll type fill before the ellipse for his mouth, and I'll keep it as red because, hey, it's a mouth. Okay, now that it looks like a bright and sunny day, Winston might want to go running. Let's give him a headband to soak up all the sweat. I'll use the line function to draw a line across his forehead. And I already know some good coordinates for that. Nice. I want this headband to be a lot thicker because he's going to sweat a lot. For that, I'll use a new command, stroke weight. And I need to pass that a number to say how thick we want this line to be. Let's try 20. It's pretty good, but I'm just gonna make it a little bigger. Okay, good. Of course, I want this headband to be more colorful. It's, you know, black, not so great. To color the headband, I have to use another new command, stroke. And let me change that to that color. That looks good. The stroke command is the way that we color the outlines of shapes and the way that we set the colors for lines. That's different from fill, which fills the inside of a shape with color. A line doesn't really have an inside, so fill will never affect a line. We also have a function that we can use to turn off outlines entirely. I'll type that up here, no stroke. Notice we now have no outlines around our face, our eyes, and our mouth. We can still see our headband because we have got that stroke command right before it. And stroke basically turns no stroke off once the program sees it. Okay, so that's what you need to know to color your drawings. The important thing is to make sure that you pay attention to the order of your commands. So you should always set the color before you draw the shapes that you want to be colored with that color. Now, go make the world a more colorful place.